Ah, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. A poem about taking the road less traveled and becoming a success. Right? Well, The Road Not Taken is perhaps the most misinterpreted poem in the 20th century, and may have even led to the death to whom Robert Frost wrote it for. But we'll get to that. Hi, I'm the Poetry Guy, and today we are going to analyze The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Let's start with the summary. Our narrator comes across a fork in the road, knowing that he can only go down one path, he decides to examine them a bit more closely. One has slightly more grass, but other than that, they are exactly the same. After pondering a bit longer, he decides to go down the second road, saving the first road to be traveled on another day. But after a while, he realizes that he might not go down that path again. After an unknown amount of time has passed, and he is much older, after giving a sigh, he decides to tell himself that he took the road less traveled by, and that made all the difference. Now for the analysis. For us to truly understand this poem, we have to understand that this poem has two tenses, present and future, with the first three stanzas happening in the present and the last stanza happening in the future. In stanza 1, our narrator comes across two roads, not knowing which one he should take. In stanza 2, he examines them and comes to the conclusion that they are the same. That's right, the roads are the same, as Frost writes, then took the other just as fair, and perhaps having the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as far as passing there, had warned them, really, about the same. So in other words, stanza 2 is saying, I went to examine the other roads, and this one looked slightly less taken care of, though as far as people walking on it, they are about equally used. In stanza 3, he makes his choice to go down the second road, even saying, I kept the first road for another day. In stanza 4, we have a time skip, and he writes, I shall be telling this with a sigh. He sighs, but why? It becomes a little bit more clearer when we read the last four lines. Some ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference? In the second to last line, he's telling a lie. He says that he took the one less traveled by, but we know from stanza 2 that the two roads were the same and equally traveled. So in other words, he's an unreliable narrator. He sighs in the beginning of stanza 4 because he wants to believe that the two roads were different and that it made a difference, but we know that's not true. Our narrator wants to tell people that he made a choice in his life and that it made him who he is today, but we know that's not true and that the roads were the same and no matter which one he would have taken, he would have ended up in the exact same place. So what is Robert Frost saying here? To understand that, we have to figure out why he actually wrote this. Robert Frost was good friends with a British poet known as Edward Thomas. Whenever Frost would come by, they would take long walks, and every now and again, they would come across a fork in the road. Whenever this would happen, Edward Thomas was always indecisive on which road to take. This inspired Frost to write The Road Not Taken, to make fun of his friend for not being able to make a decision. However, with World War I going on, Edward Thomas misinterpreted what Frost was saying. Edward Thomas was actually at the time of his life in a fork in the road himself to either sign up for the army and join the war or to live in America. Frost's poem inspired Thomas to take the road less traveled by and join the army. As a result, he was shot in the chest and killed in the battlefield. So Frost was intentionally trying to tell people to make decisions. Frost is saying, we don't know which path may lead to where, or to where it may lead. It may lead to the same place, or to a different place. But we have to make a decision. Like the narrator, we can examine the roads, but we don't know where it will lead, so don't dwell on it. Just make a decision. But after all, this is poetry, and this is but one of the many interpretations this poem has. If you have a different one, I would love to hear in the comments below. I'm the Poetry Guy, and I'll see you next time.